Lots of young people in their 20s and 30s come to me asking about the meaning of life. They say that they have found no meaning to their lives so far. This talk is for them. Hi, my name is Ashwin. I'm the Himalayan yogi. And today I want to tell you what yoga has to say about the meaning of life. Now, the meaning of life in yoga is, of course, derived from the Vedic concept of Purusharthas, and nothing has come close to defining the meaning of life like the Purusharthas. And Purusharthas just simply means meaning of human life. The Purusharthas is divided into four categories, and the first one is called Dharma. Dharma is the basis of all meaning, and without Dharma there is no meaning to life. Dharma means laws, and it's by understanding the laws of humanity and nature that we can actually find meaning. Okay, so there are already some laws that have been designed into us because of the way we have evolved and our physiology. And so one of these laws is, let's say, reciprocity. Okay, so our autonomic nervous system determines our behavior. Autonomic nervous system has been designed by evolution in all organisms to protect them from any kind of harm. So it consists of three parts. The lowest part was the first to evolve, which is called the dorsal vagus nerve, and this leads to freeze responses. So whenever there's danger, you freeze. So all your procrastination, all your depression, everything that immobilizes you is because of that part of your autonomic nervous system. Now this is not Purusharthas, this is not human behavior. This can be displayed by any animal, so we are not animals, we're slightly better, okay? Because evolution has endowed us with something more than what animals have. Now many animals also have the sympathetic nervous system, which is the second part of the nervous system. So the first part is called the dorsal vagal nerve, and that's called tamas in yoga. The second part is called rajas in yoga, and it's a sympathetic nervous system, and this is another animal nature which we have, which is there to protect us, and is definitely useful when we are under physical attack. So it helps you to fight, or it helps you to run away. Fight or flight happens from the sympathetic nervous system. And then the third part of the autonomic nervous system to evolve, which only humans seem to have, and maybe some apes like chimpanzees might have it to some extent, and this is called the ventral vagus nerve. And this in yoga is known as sattva. Sattva means, it comes from the word satya, which means true. So the true human nature. If we understand what is the true human nature, then we understand dharma. So in the true human nature involves co-creation and care and reciprocity and concern for other people. So it's not just about yourself, and it's not about depleting yourself either. So it's called mutual benefit. Whoever thinks about mutual benefit is practicing the dharma of human beings. Okay, I should also win, you should also win, and the environment should also win. So when you look for a win-win-win like that, then you're talking about human nature, or you're talking about dharma, the law. The law that we humans are naturally inclined to follow. Everyone in the world agrees with this law. There's nobody, unless they've gone into an autonomic response, autonomic nervous system response from the sympathetic nervous system, that's when they want to exploit others and only win for themselves. There's no win-win in the sympathetic nervous system. And the other one is just lose everything, right? Tamas is just lose everything and give it up. So there's the tamasic nature, there's the rajasic nature, and there's the sattvic nature. The sattvic nature is the dharma. Now I hope the concept of dharma is clear. It's all about win, win, win. So if you're ensuring that everybody is winning and everybody is getting what they need, then you are practicing the dharma. So you can practice it in your house, make sure that everybody is happy and everybody got what they needed. You can practice, including yourself, okay? All compassion starts with self-compassion. When you're compassionate towards yourself, you can be compassionate towards others. Otherwise, you can't. People are criticizing themselves, beating themselves up. They cannot practice compassion because they'll also beat up other people. All right? So once you understand that win-win-win is the only dharma, you should win, everybody else should win, and the environment should win. Do the same thing in the office. Do the same thing at home. Do the same thing wherever you go. Whoever you interact with in any short period of time, please make sure that they win, you win, and the environment wins. Once you've got dharma down, then the other meanings come forward, which is artha. Artha simply means wealth. And wealth comes to you when you practice win-win-win. If you're making somebody win, they'll keep coming back to you to keep winning, and you keep winning too. And what do you win? You win wealth. Okay, so wealth is a natural consequence. All you have to focus on is dharma, and wealth happens automatically. But for those who don't know about the techniques of creating wealth, I have created a company called the Pre-Startup Game Plan with Saurabh Khodkar. And what we do is we help people who are planning to start up to start up properly, to understand the problems, the languages, the anecdotes and the needs, which Pat Flynn calls the plan. Understand these things about your audience. Second, create a proper offer, and then everything comes around to executing that offering. So the third part is the offering, and the fourth part is marketing. So once you got the offering ready, you do the marketing and wealth will come. It's a simple formula, okay? One of my mentors, Rajiv Talreja, says business is a science. So it is a science. If you follow these four steps, you will get wealth. Okay, if anybody is struggling with wealth, please get in touch and I'll put you on to Saurabh. Have a talk with him for 60 minutes, 90 minutes, and understand what you want to do in life. All you need is clarity. Once you have clarity, putting things to work is not difficult at all. Okay, so don't struggle with wealth. It's very easy to make wealth. Very, very easy. Okay. Nobody tells you this, that it's very easy to make wealth, but you just need to learn four lessons. You need to learn the plan, you need to make the offer, you need to make the offering, and you need to do the marketing. That's it. And you'll get wealth. Wealth will come to you in 3 months. You don't have to struggle. Okay. So that's about wealth. Please don't struggle with it now that you have this method. Okay. Karma. Now, karma is something that is not discussed at all, okay? There are many textbooks, but the compilation of all those textbooks is called the Kama Sutra. And in the Kama Sutra, you'll be very surprised. It's, of course, written for men, but even women should read it. Kama Sutra is talking about how you should treat your lover, how you should treat other people's wives, your lover or wife, okay? How you should treat other people's wives, how you should treat prostitutes. And it's also telling you how you should generally initiate any kind of love. Okay, so karma means love making, and this is a really important part. It's given a lot of importance in the Purusharthas. We all want to be in a relationship. We all want to have a good loving relationship, which is also sexual, with somebody either of the opposite sex or the same sex, depending on your orientation. So learning karma is very important, and there are no lessons for karma right now. Nobody is teaching it, and I'll be coming up with lessons, but first I want you guys to sort out your dharma and artha. Okay, I'm not going to teach you karma until you sort out your dharma and artha. And there are the lessons, the textbook for it is Kama Sutra, okay? So even what I'm going to teach you is going to be based on the textbook, but of course adapted for modern times. So that's also going to bring a lot of meaning into your life. When you have the love of another person and you understand very deeply what is relationships, otherwise you'll just, you know, go get married and you'll have an empty relationship. You won't have it full of joy and energy, life force energy. And this is a very important meaning of life. If you don't have a good relationship with your life partner, then what are you going to do? You're going to have a miserable life, even if you have a lot of wealth, even if you're following the win-win-win, even if you're following the dharma and you have a lot of wealth. If your karma is not sorted out properly, you'll either be frustrated sexually or you'll be very badly abused in a relationship. So learning how to have a proper relationship which is both loving and sexual is karma. And this is considered a very important part in yoga, okay? So many people might argue with me saying celibacy is a part of yoga, but brahmacharya does not mean celibacy. Brahmacharya means continence, not wasting your sexual energy, pushing it to a sexual pursuit that comes back to you. Every sexual pursuit is an investment where energy comes back to you. So that's what karma is all about. Everybody tries to jump to the moksha. They want to know about kundalini, they want to know about energy, they want to know. Don't jump there. Have you got your karma sorted out? Then I'll teach you moksha. Okay? Moksha is you moving towards God, leaving all of these things and moving towards God. Okay? So that's when for you the karma doesn't matter, the artha doesn't matter, but the dharma still matters. The dharma carries through all through and carries meaning. But when the karma and the artha, you've had enough of it, that's when it doesn't matter. Okay, when you had none of it, if you go and renounce the world, then you're not going to be able to renounce the world because it will keep pulling you back. Okay, you'll never be able to have a single thought about God or the divine, and you'll never be able to become one with the divine. Unless you know how to love other human beings, unless you know how to create wealth by being of value, you're not going to be able to liberate yourself from samsara or the earth itself. And you're not going to be able to be one with God. Okay. Now that part is called moksha. Moksha means liberation. And what are you liberating yourself from? You're liberating yourself from suffering, not from another birth. Even if you do take another birth, which is highly unlikely that you'll have memories of this birth, because consciousness is there in every atom, in every molecule. When it comes together to form a human being, then there's a certain consciousness saying I am. But this I am is called Atman, and it's there in every part, every particle, every wave of energy has a sense of I am. When it combines together, then it forms a combined sense of I am. It'll never recombine in the same way. Okay, this is your only birth. If it dissolves, you've lost nothing. Life is not lost. Only your life is lost. Your life is whatever. My life, let's say. My life as Ashwin the Himalayan yogi will be gone when I die. So, but somewhere you've created that energy. You've created a very strong movement of energy. When you reconstruct yourself, you're going to fall into that energy again. And you're going to look for moksha again, even though you have no memories of any previous births. That's how rebirth happens. It's not one soul that goes out. Everything has an Atman, which is the sense of I am. Okay? A sense of I am gets reformed. But if you've created one connection with the divine, then that continues for some time, and then you can reform again in that connection. And that's what is a lineage that's passed on in yoga from teacher to teacher to teacher to teacher. The focus is on the spiritual, because it's easy to reject the world when you're a failure at it, right? So if you fail at everything in the world, then you want to be a yogi. This is not acceptable in my akhada. We don't accept people who have not succeeded in artha and karma to learn moksha. Okay, so anyway, this is the meaning of life. All the four parts are very important and very valuable for you to practice. It doesn't matter what your age is, even if you're 5 years old, you can start on the dharma and you can start on the artha. But of course, you have to wait till you're a certain age before you start on the karma. That's till you're 18 or 21. So please follow the law. And you've got to also follow the law of the land. That is also part of dharma. Okay? So you don't go and break any laws, not pay your income tax, cheat on your GST. Please don't do all those things, because you have to follow the law of the land. If you get into trouble with the law, then all of your meaning in life is gone. Okay, so stay out of legal trouble. That is also part of dharma. I hope this talk was useful to you to find meaning in your life. And if you need any more help and you still feel meaningless, head over to yogilifestyle.org and book that call with me. There's a call you can book there to talk with me to regulate your autonomic nervous system and to create a proper future timeline for yourself. People have turned their life around with this one call to me. Alright, so I take this personally, no assistance. I take this call personally. You schedule it, you talk to me, and then I will help you to figure out how you can regulate your autonomic system and then come to sattva. If you come to sattva, you'll be able to easily follow the dharma. And if you follow the dharma, the artha and the karma will come. Okay, there's learning to be done. I haven't taught the karma lessons yet because all of you are stuck in artha itself. So many people who come to me saying, I don't have meaning in my life, is because they're not even making money. Alright? So learn how to make money. Life becomes meaningful already because you're following the dharma and you're being sattvic. So learn how to regulate the autonomic system and come to sattva. This is the base of all yoga practice. And I'm giving it out really cheap. Usually I charge 21,000 for the call. But right now for the first 100 people, I'm charging only 499 rupees. And even international people get the same rate, so it's hardly anything. Go book that call and I will see you in the call and start you off on your path of yoga. Alright, thank you very much for asking the question and thank you very much for watching. If you're one of those who asked the question, you have to share this with your friends because they're asking the same question too. Alright, thank you very much and I will see you in my next video.